Myself, Dr. Humaira. I am from JT Arts Science and Commerce College, Foroman, Malegaon. My topic is pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration is the physical movement of air into and out of the respiratory tract. A single breath or respiratory cycle consists of an inhalation or inspiration and an exhalation or expiration. Okay, breathing functions to maintain adequate alveolar ventilation, the movement of air into and out of the alveoli. Air will flow from an area of higher pressure to an area of low pressure, and this is the basis of pulmonary ventilation. Occurs when changes in the volume of lungs create pressure gradients. These pressure differences causes air to move into or out of the respiratory tract. When the lungs expand, pressure falls inside the airways and air moves into the respiratory tract. When lungs contract, pressure increases and air moves out of the respiratory tract. The figure itself shows that the function of the ribs, lungs and diaphragm. The right side of the figure shows that changes occur during the inspiration, and the right side figure shows the changes occur during the expiration. So in this process, the volume of lungs depend on the volume of pleural cavities. The parietal and pleural membranes are separated. Only a thin film of pleural fluid at the start of the breath. What happens? Pressure inside and outside of the lungs are identical and there is no movement of air. When the thoracic cavity enlarges, which is shown in the left side figure, the pressure inside the lungs decreases. Air now enters the respiratory passages because the pressure inside of the lung is lower than atmospheric pressure. And during breathing, enlargement of thoracic cavity involves the contraction of the diaphragm. The muscular sheet that separates the thoracic and abdominal pelvic cavities, aided by the external intercostal muscles. In the same way, the diaphragm forms the floor of the thoracic cavity. When relaxed, the diaphragm has the shape of the dome and projects upwards into thoracic cavity, compressing the lungs, which is shown in the right side figure. When the diaphragm contracts, it flattens and increases the volume of thoracic cavity. Expanding the lungs, contraction of the diaphragm is controlled by the phrenic nerves and cervical plexus. The external intercostal elevates the ribcage. Because of the nature of the articulation between ribs and vertebrae, this movement increases the volume of thoracic cavity. Contraction of the external intercostals is controlled by intercostal nerves. Downward movement of rib cage and upward movement of diaphragm reverse the process and reduce the size of the lungs. Pressure inside the lungs now exceeds atmospheric pressure and air moves out of the lungs. During quiet breathing, Expansion of the lung stretches their elastic fibers. In addition, elevation of the rib cage stretches opposing skeletal muscles and elastic fibers in the body wall. When the inspiratory muscles relax, these elastic components recoil, returning the diaphragm and rib cage to their original position. When breathing heavily, contractions of the internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles may assist in exhalation. In such a way, inhalation or inspiration and exhalation or expiration occurs due to the changes in intercostal muscles, diaphragm, and thoracic cavity. In such a way, the pulmonary ventilation is performed. So, thank you very much.